Facebook, it turns out, was using some standard campaign tactics to deal with all the accusations of privacy and Russian interference.
Right, exactly. So, you know, there was a research firm that was essentially trying to tie some of the company's critics to the billionaire financier, George Soros. Now, of course, George Soros actually was funding some of those groups, but his Open Society Foundations has told us that it wasn't because of the anti-Facebook activities. What has now happened is that using campaign tactics, opposition research against a nonprofit, even if it is one sort of somewhat funded by George Soros, has really landed the company in hot water, and Facebook has fired the public affairs firm that was doing that research.
Ben, is Facebook concerned about any more regulation now that could be on the horizon?
Absolutely. I think Facebook and the whole tech world really is looking at possibly at a privacy bill this coming year. Now we have a divided government between Democrats and Republicans. It's not exactly clear if that would be able to make it through. But Facebook in specific is also facing an FTC investigation about the Cambridge Analytica hack. So the outcome of that is something that they may be looking at in the next weeks and months. This probably won't affect it, but it is something that they're looking at anyway.
Very quickly, Ben, is it a better situation for Facebook that the Democrats now control the House?
Probably not. At this point, they're essentially looking to legislate, and they have sort of run out of patience with the company, not least of all because of the role that they believe it played in electing Donald Trump.